Hello to all Formula E fans, supporters, and partners in Indonesia. That Formula E will be racing on the streets of Jakarta. The vibrant. My name is Alberto Longo. I'm the co-founder and chief championship officer of the ABB FIA Formula E World Championship. It gives me great pleasure to confirm that Formula E will be racing on the streets of Jakarta, the vibrant capital city of Indonesia, with a population of 11 million people next year on the 4th of June. 2 years after we first announced the Jakarta E-Prix, there has never been a more compelling time to focus the eyes of the world on Indonesia and shine a light on the effort being made across the country to recover from the devastating environmental impact of climate change and the unprecedented effects of the global pandemic. In fact, the 2 years delay since announcing the Jakarta E-Prix has actually increased the interest and conversation around Formula E in national media and social media. With the innovative changes to our qualifying format that were just announced yesterday, it promises to be an incredibly exciting event for drivers, teams, and Formula E fans. We're confident that even casual sport fans across Indonesia and around the world will love the excitement of head-to-head racing in the new qualifying format and will quickly fall in love with our sport when they discover it. Hosting an E-Prix in Indonesia next year is good news for both Formula E and Indonesia. Formula E has a huge, passionate fan base amongst the 280 million population. A large proportion of that fan base is the younger, progressive millennial generation, and we know that for Indonesia, hosting Formula E is an important tool for promoting the EV industry and the clean energy. Under the leadership of President Joko Widodo, Indonesia has stated it is serious in its goal of moving from conventional to more environmentally friendly energy. In addition, I know the president has the ambition to put Indonesia at the center stage of global electric car and battery production and capitalize on the growth market. Indonesia is already well known as the world's biggest producer of high-quality nickel, which is a key component in the batteries of electric vehicles, for example. Jakarta is taking action to improve its air quality, with around 70% of carbon pollution in the city produced by car. Jakarta Governor Anies Baswedan wrote to me personally to express his belief that shifting from private cars to public transport and promoting the use of electric vehicles is the way to go, by saying, "It is an intergenerational effort. Engaging the millennials is key for success, and Formula E is an effective tool in helping achieve that crucial goal." Finally, it's great to hear that Indonesia is back in business, with tourists and investors returning as life gets back to normal. Data shows that the government's economic measures and agility during the COVID crisis means Indonesia and Jakarta are showing a strong signs of economic recovery after 2 years of slowdown. In the second quarter of this year, the Jakarta and Indonesian economy grew by a 10.9% and a 7.1% respectively, year on year. Anies also wrote to me, "We need the support from the international community to ensure that the economic recovery continues." With the Jakarta E-Prix finally taking place in June next year, we will support that mission by activating the global fan base of Formula E and focusing their attention on your incredible country, Indonesia. Thank you so much for listening to this message. I cannot wait to see you on the 4th of June.